2018 is upon us, or perhaps here, and this is a perfect time for people to make resolutions, as they always do. But as often happens, New Year's resolutions fall apart pretty quickly. If you exercise in January, you may notice a huge influx of people and then notice it kind of peter away by February or March. And it's good for you if you've been working out that long and like a less crowded environment. But I think it's probably a good idea to try and stick to your resolutions if you're going to make them. I don't really make mine at New Year's. I make them when I feel like it's time to make them. But this isn't, maybe I can make another one. So there are a few scientifically proven ways to increase your likelihood to stick to your New Year's resolution. One of which is to reduce activation effort. So activation effort would be like the effort for you to do something. So if you wanted to, let's say you wanted to learn how to play the guitar, but the guitar is in a box, in the closet, in the other room, on the highest shelf. This is gonna sound very stupid. It's gonna be harder for you to get there, so you're less likely to do it. But if you put the guitar next to your bed, you're not even gonna think about it, and you're gonna go instead and grab the guitar. This comes from Sean Ocker's 20-second rule, and he is a happiness researcher, according to himself. So I know I just made it sound very not reliable, but I think it's certainly a principle worth trying, at least if that is something closer to what your resolution is. If you want to be more productive, it has been said, and I've seen this in advice to students or college students cramming, or maybe you shouldn't be cramming, but if you must cram, take more breaks. So it has been found in the Journal of Applied Psychology that frequent short breaks that begin as early as a couple of hours after you start your workday can make you more effective and refreshed, and you would not overwork, and overwork can lead to stress, and for stress, hormones to be increased. So try that one. Some research shows that people are happier when they spend their money on experience versus obtaining material goods. And I'm a little bit of a material good overuser, aka hoarder. So I would probably want to do this while I can, at least. You know, maybe you're like me and you've seen a few people at the end of their lives, maybe not as fulfilled as they might be. This is a good way to allay that, at least. According to neuroscientist Sandra Amont, author of Why Diets Make Us Fat, the way to lose weight is to stop focusing on your weight. So her assertion, and you may disagree with this, is that our brain controls our body weight at a set point within 10 to 15 pounds because we are hardwired for survival. So when you enter a diet, your brain may perceive this as a threat and increase stress hormones, which are linked to increased weight gain. Her idea is to instead not focus on that, but instead do regular exercise, make good food choices, reduce your stress, and over time this happens. And I know you'll want to lose the weight right away, but that typically doesn't work as well. Don't do a juice cleanse. Maybe I'll do a video on why juice cleanses are a bad idea, but you have a liver, don't do a juice cleanse. So we've heard before in a lot of pop science articles that it takes about 20 days to form a new habit, but some research has found that it's closer to 66 days, over 2 months of time to stick to something. So you'd have to give it more time for a habit to stick if you're trying to focus on making more good habits. If you skip a day or miss a day, don't beat yourself up too badly, just get back on it and not think about it too hard and punish yourself, which is what Kim does. Lastly, and this is gonna sound weird, choose a resolution that doesn't require a lot of willpower. Let me explain. A body of research has found that when people exert extreme willpower, drastically changing what you are doing in your everyday life right away, it exhausts other functions in your brain, such as mental endurance and your will to achieve this and follow through. So it's something that you have to train yourself to do instead of just immediately jump into it so hard. It is recommended instead that you choose a resolution that enriches your life with something instead of taking it away, such as deciding that you're going to take a walk every morning, or you're going to join a book club, or learn a new skill, instead of deciding I'm not eating sugar at all, or I'm not going to watch TV at all. So that may be a more way, a more easy way to achieve success in your goal, as it were. I have one personal way to make your New Year's great. Okay, on December 31st at 10:36 and 22 seconds, you start playing Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. And when the clock strikes midnight, Hermione will punch Draco in the face. Live your life right the Kim way. Audience, what are you doing for your New Year's resolution? Please let us know below and like and subscribe for more.